It's not because I'd read the books. Childbirth without fear. Birthing from within, or anything by Ina May Gaskin. And it's not because I'd searched home birth chat forums or Facebook groups to answer the questions I'd been asking. And it's not because I had a birth pool or had a doula and listened to what she had to say, practiced self-hypnosis or drank raspberry tea 3 times a day. It's not because of any of these things, though I did all of them and more. It's simply because I'm a woman, and it's what my body was designed for. We've seen what childbirth looks like on TV, right? Women lying on their backs on a strange and unfamiliar bed, fear and screaming, stainless steel, the panic and the dread. But what if the horror and the trauma can sometimes be a self-fulfilling prophecy? What if the received wisdom that birth is dangerous and unpleasant is simply a cultural attitude that we can change when we just listen. Listen to our bodies and the knowledge they possess. Listen to our rhythms when we need things to progress. We are part of a process as old as life itself, ingrained in our DNA, way older than waiting times and targets, and an overstretched NHS. And yet, birth happens best when it's undisturbed, when it's dark and it's quiet and it's unobserved. Birth requires 100% concentration and focus. And we can't do that when the locus of control is outside of ourselves. We need to feel safe and loved. We need to feel trust. And yet it seems so unjust that we're not being allowed to give birth unimpeded at our own pace in a quiet and dark and familiar space. So if you're planning to give birth, please know this one thing, that fear causes tension and that causes pain. When we can relax, we can manage the strain. You can do your own research and find out how to prepare to free the wisdom within us. That's a truth we must share.